should really win this at least 3-1.
Let's see this opening points. I just got cut off there because looking at the way that Stefanova approached it. Now, we saw the first few points against Monfadini when Diaz played in the first match. It was all Monfadini, wasn't it?
Yeah. And wow. What Monfadini was doing so well was getting Diaz around, moving her from side to side, getting her into the positions that she actually likes to be in, a bit further away. But that backhand, wasn't it, to the wide forehand was so bloodthirsty. And I feel as though Stefanova here, with her backhand, she's going to try and rip it cross table as much as possible. But Diaz has better serves than Melanie, more power, quicker. Obviously doesn't have the pimples on the back, on the forehand either. What a point here. Controlled chop, lobbing. Great point.
Some good returns there from Diaz, but on the defensive.
So far, so entertaining.
Yeah, agreed.
Would you expect anything less?
No, it has been in keeping with this tie so far.
Diaz here struggling with that serve.
Well, they might be on the brink of something quite special here, Italy.
Another first meeting as well here between these two. Seen a lot of them. I think every match has been a first meeting. I'm not sure about.
Yeah, there is. Vladimir thinking to himself, this could be real trouble for Puerto Rico. It's not the greatest body language we're seeing at the moment from Diaz either, is it?
I've seen a lot of resentment of the situation in the body language of the Puerto Ricans at times. Particularly Melanie in that first one. She didn't look like she wanted to be out there.
Yeah, it wasn't the best, was it?
Diaz really has to rise to this.
And from Stefanova's point of view, you just cannot open the door. You cannot give her any ray of hope to get back into this. Because we're talking about a quality player. And it's just two quick points here that Diaz has gained to halve that lead.
They've both been decent behind serves, haven't they?
Yeah. I mean, you look back at this, Italy winning the women's team event at the European Table Tennis Championships in 2003. They're not an established table tennis nation, and yet to beat some of the big wigs in Europe, that's a great achievement for Italy back in the day.
Well, for sure. It's been a long time since they've even seen a world medal, right?
Right. So, good times then. And she'd love to recall them. And that's really good from Diaz. This has been excellent from her. Very, very good run of points from the Puerto Rican. She's now in front.
Great receive, though. Diaz can't calibrate the counter. I'd be serving into the forehand if I was Diaz. A lot more.
Why would you do that?
Just to stop Stefanova from being able to get that flick into play.
She was looking to take the pace off that.
That wasn't a particularly well-played point from Adriana. Got away with it a bit.
Right. Yeah, some unforced errors here from Stefanova that have just maybe let her down a little bit. And it's Diaz who's got a couple of game points here.
Good serve. Nice punch.
Yeah, nicely done. And Diaz, it took her a while to get there, though.
Yeah. She's doing it again into the forehand. And then you can just see already she's got an advantageous position at the table. Her reaction towards her dad was as I said, I could have made that so much easier for myself if I would have done that earlier. Well,
why didn't you?
Yeah. Right. Beautiful spin there. Oh, but she misses that one.
Good start. Shake of the head there from Stefanova.
Oh, she didn't think it was going to land. Diaz never looked in doubt.
Now, remember, we told you what a great player she used to be in the past. Stefanova. Her biggest ever win was defeating the great Li Nan. World number 7. At the German Open. No, that was more than 20 years ago, 2003.
Since then, won medals at the 2005, 7, 8 and 9 European Championships. Kind of a pioneer for Italy, really. Definitely say the same about Adriana Diaz. Double bouncer, that was great length. Lee Stefanova shaking her head, scratching it to be more specific. Look at this here.
Yeah, two bounce, that's right.
Perfect.
Yeah, this is a much better second game for Adriana Diaz and probably how many people thought it would have gone. Not much change of reaction there from Vladimir.
There it is.
Dispatched it.
We said that for Adriana Diaz to get to that next step, to become a top five player, she needs to become more forehand orientated. And there was the pivot.
Oh, not far away, going round the table.
The eyes of the content managers there lit up, because that would have been yes, spectacular around the net.
It would have. I love that backhand there from Stefanova. It's just really clean, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a very fluid stroke. An elegant backhand she has.
Didn't work that time. Those game points quickly converted. Adriana Diaz.
It is a dream come true. I never thought I'd be doing this as a small kid.
So Diaz here is two up here. I know the backhand let her down there at the last, but it is, like we said earlier, it's just really good to see on that backhand, Stefanova.
Yeah. She's just trying to feed off the pace a little bit. And Adriana's happy to just feel it back again and again until she gets a clear-cut chance to just hit a bullet.
So, we are back here with Adriana Diaz, 3-1 up. Sorry, not sorry from Stefanova. She needs all the points she can get right now.
Would you be apologetic, Shahzad? I can't imagine you would be.
Nah, not really bothered about protocols.
Comes across, mate.
Not one for tradition, my friend. Well, Stefanova and needs to do something pretty quick, doesn't she, if she wants to arrest this slide, pull one back for Italy to stay in this match.
Nice play there. Biding her time a bit, Adriana Diaz.
Nothing she could do about that, Stefanova. And look, Diaz is inside the finish line here, as we, to be fair, predicted she would be. And as it says now, it comes down to that last match of whether Ana Diaz can stand up to the pressure. This one is looks like it's done and dusted, doesn't it? Look at that. It has been a huge, huge shift in favour. There's 7 match points, 23 of the last 32 going her way. Are they changing that, maybe?
Have to watch that one back again, Shazad. I thought it went on.
Bit of contention.
But I mean, maybe Stefanova volleyed it at the back before it hit the table. Maybe it wouldn't have hit the table, though. No. Not clear, but.
Okay,
anyway.
Well, they've awarded it eventually to Stefanova. It doesn't matter, does it? And we have 6 match points. Beautifully done from Stefanova, rolling back the years there. Fantastic on the backhand, as we've said before. Still facing 5 match points, though.
Even better.
That's a forehand now. Well, she saved 3. Stefanova.
It's like a training drill.
It was really good to watch, but Adriana Diaz.